On the other hand, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ, indeed those people who, سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ, it preceded for them. مِنَّا, from us, الْحُسْنَ, the best reward. That, on the other hand, on the contrary, those people, the worshippers of Allah, those servants of Allah who worshipped Him, for whom سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ, it preceded for them, it went ahead for them, it already passed for them. What already passed for them? Minna, from us, al-husna. So sabaqat lahum what? Al-husna. Meaning, already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that for them they will be husna. Sabaqat lahum minna al-husna, meaning Allah already knew in His knowledge that they will have al-husna. And what does al-husna refer to? Jannah. Or sabaqat lahum minna al-husna has also been understood as that they got the news in the dunya, that they will have al-husna in the hereafter. Such as the prophets of Allah. Such as some righteous servants of Allah, like for example, some of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ who were given the good news of entering into paradise while they were still in dunya. So for such people, أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبَعَدُونَ, they will be distanced, removed, far away from hellfire. They'll be removed far away from hellfire. Who? The righteous servants of Allah. And this can be understood in two ways. That those righteous servants of Allah who were worshipped by people, such as Isa alayhi salam, or Zayd alayhi salam, or other righteous prophets and servants of Allah whom other people began worshipping, praying to, so such, Allah will not put them in hellfire. He will not put them in hellfire. Such servants of Allah will be distanced away from hellfire. And we can also understand this ayah in the general sense, that those people who worshipped Allah, who did good, they will be removed away from hellfire. We learn in Surah Yunus ayah 26, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَ وَزِيَادَ. For those people who do ihsan, for them is al-husna, the good reward, and also more. And in Surah Al-Rahman, ayah 60, we learn, هَلْ جَزَاهُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. Is there any reward for ihsan except ihsan? So just as they did good in this world, Allah will make their final abode good as well. They were good in the dunya, Allah will make their end good. He will save them from punishment, He will save them from any harm in the hereafter, and He will give al-husna to them. To such an extent that لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا, they will not even hear its slightest sound. Whose? The sound of hellfire. حَسِيس is from حِس, and حِس, as you know, is sense. So حَسِيس is the slightest sound. It's the faintest sound of something. So they will not even hear the slightest sound of hellfire. Because the hellfire, it's actually very loud. تَكَادُ تَمَيَّزُ مِنَ الْغَيْظِ. It's as though it's boiling out of anger. It's that loud. But we see that these righteous servants of Allah, they will not even be made to hear the hellfire. وَهُمْ فِي, and they will be in, مَشْتَهَتْ أَنْفُسُهُمْ, what their souls desire, and they will be in that, خَالِدُونَ, abiding therein eternally. In Surah Fussilat, ayah 31, we learn, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. In Jannah you will have whatever your souls desire, and in Jannah you will have whatever you request, whatever you call for. So they will be in Jannah enjoying whatever they wish, and they will be in Jannah خَالِدُونَ, eternally. لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ, they will not be grieved by the greatest terror. The greatest terror is not going to grieve them. It's not going to make them sad. It's not going to make them worry. What is this الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ, the greatest faza? Faza, as you know, is used for terror. It is used for a state of panic and alarm. When a person is extremely afraid because he has experienced something very terrifying, something very horrifying. So you can imagine al-faza' as when a person is extremely fearful because of a traumatic experience. So al-faza' al-akbar, the greatest terror. What is the greatest terror? According to some, this refers to death. So la yahzunuhum, the experience of death is not going to make them sad. Because their experience of death is also going to be a good one. Because the angels, as they will come to take their soul, they're going to do so in a good way. They're going to be giving good news to them. Some have said that Al-Faza'ul Akbar, the greatest terror, it refers to the blowing of the trumpet. Because when the trumpet will be blown, any creature that is alive, what's going to happen to it? It's going to die. And the second time that it's going to be blown, what's going to happen? Everyone is going to come alive. Imagine the intensity of that sound, that the dead are going to be shaken alive. Just imagine. If a person is sleeping and you have an extremely loud alarm, what happens? They wake up. They will jump up. Now you can imagine how severe and loud the sound is, that it's going to shake the dead. It's going to make them alive. So this Faza'ul Akbar, it's not going to terrify them. Some have said that Al-Faza'ul Akbar refers to the terror of resurrection and the Day of Judgment, and all of the following events. They will not be grieved at that time. They'll be saved from horror at that time. Others have said that Al-Faza'ul Akbar may also refer to the death of death, when death will be brought in the form of a black ram and it will be slaughtered. So at that time also, they will not be sad, they will not be terrified. And some have said that Al-Faza'ul Akbar, the supreme fear, refers to that a person be sentenced to hellfire. لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ They will not be terrified. This will not grieve them. Whether it's the blowing of the trumpet, or it's death before that, or it's the accounting in the grave, or it's the terror of resurrection, the events of the Day of Judgment, this will not grieve them. Why? Because وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ And the angels are going to meet them. The angels are going to receive them. تَتَلَقَّى is to receive someone happily. At the time of death, the angels will be receiving them, welcoming them. And also, at the time of resurrection, the angels will be receiving them, welcoming them, giving them good news. And what will they say? That هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ This is your day which you were promised. This is your day, يَوْمُكُمْ When do we say to someone, this is your day? When do we say that? When they're, for example, getting married, or when a child, it's his birthday, or it's graduation, or something like that. It's your day, meaning you're the most special one today. Whatever you say will happen. Every wish of yours will be granted. Importance will be given to you. You are the priority today. So, هَذَا يَوْمُكُمْ This is your day, الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ Which you were promised in the life of the world. We learned that after the second blowing of the horn, of the trumpet, when all the people will be resurrected, and the criminals, the guilty ones, they will be in extreme terror. But the righteous, they will not grieve. They will be in safety. The horrors and the terrors of that day will not grieve them. Why? Because they were well prepared. They did something to prepare for that day. They did something to save themselves from the horror of that day. And on top of that, they will have the company of the angels. The angels will receive them. They will greet them. And they will comfort them. In Surah Maryam, Ayah 85, we learned earlier that يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا On the day that we will gather the righteous to the most merciful as a delegation. So as soon as the righteous will be resurrected, their good deeds will be awaiting. That we were on you in the dunya, today you come upon us. And the angels will receive them. And they will take them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the form of a delegation. This is just like when a person arrives at the airport. One person comes, he doesn't find anyone to receive him. No one to receive him. He has to go find a taxi himself. He has to go get his luggage himself. He has to load it himself. And he has to go to his destination himself. And the other is that a person comes, and there are people waiting for him at every stop, at every location. People who are waiting for him. As soon as he comes off the aircraft, somebody comes, welcoming him, taking his bag from him, telling him to go and sit in the waiting lounge, we will get all of your luggage, your car is waiting, your guests are there, your friends are there, your family is there. وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ When a person is given this royal treatment, things become so easy for him. He does not experience any fear, any panic at all. So we see that as soon as they will emerge from their graves, the angels will come to them. And they will come to them with words, هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ. In Surah Al-Naml, ayah number 87, we learn, وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ وَكُلٌ أَتَوْهُ دَاخِرِينَ. And on the day when the horn will be blown, whoever is in the heavens and the earth will be terrified except those whom Allah wills. Everyone will be terrified except who? Those whom Allah wills. In Surah Fussilat, ayah 30-32, we learn, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Those who said, our Lord is Allah, and then they remained steadfast. They did not worship Allah conditionally. No, they remained firm. What will happen to them? تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels will descend upon them. And what will the angels say to them? أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْسَنُوا. Don't fear, don't grieve. وَأَبَشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ. And receive the good news of Jannah which you were promised. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We were your friends in dunya and we are also your friends in the hereafter. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. And you will have whatever that your souls desire. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. And you will have whatever that you ask for. In Surah Al-Nahl, ayah number 32, we learn, الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ طَيِّبِينَ يَقُولُونَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. The ones whom the angels take in death being good and pure. So their state was of being طَيِّب. And when the angels, they take their soul at the time of death, what do they say? سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Peace be on you. And they tell them, أُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Enter Jannah because of what you used to do. So we see that those servants of Allah who are righteous, who worship Allah, who become steadfast, who do not worship Allah conditionally, but in every circumstance, who remain sabir, who remain abid, who remain salih, then what will happen to them? In every stage of the akhirah, every stage of the akhirah, from the time of death until they're admitted into Jannah, there will be angels comforting them, telling them, don't grieve, don't be sad, everything will be okay. When you're going through a difficult experience, and even if one person tells you, it's okay, you'll make it, isn't it so encouraging? It's so comforting. Just one person is telling you, you can do it, it's okay. Imagine, angels will be comforting them. يَوْمَ نَطْوِي السَّمَاءَ. The day when we will fold the heaven. نَطْوِي, from the root letters, طَا وَاوْ يَا, from the word طَي. And طَي is to fold up something. It is to roll up something, to wind up something. So the day that we're going to roll up the sky, just as كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ, like the folding, like the wrapping up, like the rolling up of a sijil. What is a sijil? A sijil is anything on which something is written. So you can imagine a sijil like a scroll, like a sheet, like a record, a register. And lil kutub, al kutub is a plural of kitab. And over here it gives a meaning of lil kitaba. So just as the scroll that is used for kitaba, that is used for writing, is rolled up, this is how the skies are going to be rolled up. You understand? كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. Which sijil? Which scroll? Which is used for kitaba, which is used for lilkutub, for the purpose of writing. So the scroll, which is opened up, you write whatever you want to on it. And then what do you do? What do you do? You roll it up. Isn't it so? Similarly, a notebook, you open it up, you write whatever you have to, and then what do? You close it. So كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ, in the same manner, the skies are going to be rolled up. كَمَا بَدَأْنَا. Right now we see them spread open, we see them so vast. فَرْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ. Allah tells us again and again to look into the sky. Do you see any fault? Any kind of hole in the sky? You don't see. So the sky is massive, it's huge. Anywhere you look, you see the sky above you. But this whole sky, Allah says, is going to be wrapped up on the Day of Judgment. كَمَا بَدَأْنَا, just as we initiated أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ, the first creation. That just as we initiated your creation, نُعِيدُهُ, we will repeat it. Just as we initiated your creation, we're going to repeat it. Meaning just as we brought you into existence, we're going to create you again. We're going to recreate you. وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا, this is a promise upon us. إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ, indeed we are ones who will do this. So we see that on the Day of Judgment, the heaven will be rolled up as the scribe rolls up a written scroll. From another verse of the Quran, we learn that the heaven, the skies, currently are expanding. In Surah Al-Dhariyat, Ayah 47, we learn, وَالسَّمَاءَ بَنَيْنَاهَا بِأَيْدٍ وَإِنَّا لَمُوسِعُونَ, and the sky, we have constructed it with strength, and indeed we are expanding it. So right now, the sky is being, the space is, the universe is expanding. But on the Day of Judgment, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? It's going to be rolled up. It's going to be closed up together. In Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 67, we learn, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, they have not appraised Allah with true appraisal, while the earth entirely will be within His grip on the Day of Judgment. The entire earth will be in the grip of Allah on the Day of Judgment. وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ, and the heavens will be folded, they'll be rolled up, مَطْوِيَّات, same root, they'll be rolled up in His right hand. سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ, exalted is He and high above what they associate with Him. Recitation. The Prophet ﷺ was sent as a mercy for the people. He was not sent to pray against the people, to make their lives miserable, to make their lives difficult. No. He came to create peace, to spread peace, to free people from the slavery of others and make them the slaves of Allah. قُلْ, say, إِنَّمَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ, indeed it has been revealed to me that أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. This is the main message that has been revealed to me, that indeed your God is who? One God. إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ, one God. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ, then will you submit? Will you submit to Allah? Will you submit to Him and worship Him alone, or will you do other things? فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, but if they turn away, despite your telling them, despite your warning them, they don't pay heed to what you tell them. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ, then say, أَذَنْتُكُمْ عَلَى سَوَاءٍ, I have announced to you equally. Adhantu, from the root letters Hamza, Dal, Noon. And what does Adhan mean? To proclaim, to announce, to inform. This is the literal meaning of the word Adhan. So when the Adhan is given, what are the people informed of? That the time of Salah has entered. It has come, it has begun. And very soon the Salah will start in the masjid. So Adhantukum, I have informed you, I have announced you. About what? Announced to you about the ahkam of Allah, about the message that your Lord has sent to you. And I have informed you of it ala sawa. What does it mean by this ala sawa? That I have told you fully and completely. All that I have been told, I have informed you about it. You and me are like sawa now, in knowledge of this matter. Whatever I have been informed of, I have told you. What do we learn in Surah Al-Ma'idah? That the Prophet ﷺ was told, بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ, convey all that has been revealed to you from your Lord. And don't hide anything of it. So فَقُلْ أَذَنْتُكُمْ عَلَى سَوَاءٍ, I have told you completely, fully, clearly, every detail I have told you. وَإِنْ أَدْرِي, and I do not know, I have no idea, that أَقَرِيبٌ, whether it is near, أَمْ بَعِيدٌ, or it is far. What is near or far? مَا تُعَدُونَ, what you were promised. Because the people of Mecca, in their defiance, in their denial, what would they say? We're not going to believe, bring the punishment. So the Prophet ﷺ is told to tell them that I have told you fully whatever I knew of, and I have warned you, and I don't know whether your punishment, whether your outcome is near or it is far. إِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْجَهْرَ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. Indeed, he knows what is declared of speech. Who? Allah knows. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْتُمُونَ. And he knows what you conceal. Because وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوِجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تُبْدُونَ وَمَا تَكْتُمُونَ. So whether you hide it or you say it out loud, your denial, your mockery, your disbelief, Allah knows very well. Your doubts, He knows very well. وَإِنْ أَدْرِي. And I do not know. لَعَلَّهُ. Perhaps it. فِتْنَةٌ is a trial. لَكُمْ for you. What is a trial for you? The respite that you have. This تَأْخِيرُ الْعَذَابِ, that the punishment is not coming immediately. I don't know the reason as to why exactly the punishment is not coming upon you. But perhaps it is a trial for you. It's a fitna for you. Then what do you do? Do you become more defiant? Or do you turn to Allah? وَمَتَاعٌ إِلَىٰ حِينٍ. And perhaps it is just an enjoyment for some time. Perhaps Allah is just giving you some more time to enjoy, and then He will eventually catch you. Then eventually He'll punish you. So what does this ayah show to us? That if a person is wrong, if a person is doing something wrong, he should not think that just because I'm not getting caught, I am right. No. This is what? A fitna. This is a test. That a person is being given more time. What does he do? Does he change his ways after realizing his mistake, or does he become stubborn? قَالَ رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ. The Prophet has said, O Lord, my Lord, judge with the truth. أُحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ. That, O my Lord, judge with the truth. Between who? Between myself and those who deny me, those who reject me. And judge bilhaq, make a decision that is the truth. That come, make the truth be dominant, and make the truth established. وَرَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانِ. And He has said that our Lord is the most merciful. المستعان, the one whose help is sought. عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ, against what you describe. What is it that the mushrikeen of Makkah did in the description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They ascribed children to Him. They ascribed partners to Him. So, وَرَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. And against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what all had they? تَصِفُونَ. They called him a sha'ir. They called him a kahin. They called him a kadhib. They called him many names. They mocked at him. They made fun of him. They ridiculed him in public. Verbally abused him. So what does the Prophet say? وَرَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. That our Lord, He is the one whose help I seek against what you say. And this is the way that every da'i should adopt. That when people are attacking you, when people are opposing you, who should you seek help of? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we see this in all of the prophets of Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when the people threw him into the fire, what did he say? Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. When Ayyub alayhi salam was going through difficulty, what did he say? Anni massani ad-durru wa anta arhamur rahimin. Zakariya alayhi salam, when he wanted something, Rabbi la tadharni fardan wa anta khayrul warithin. So this is the way of the prophets of Allah. They ask Allah for help. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well, رَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. In Surah Al-A'raf, ayah 89, we learn, رَبَّنَا افْتَحْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ قَوْمِنَا بِالْحَقِّ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْفَاتِحِينَ. The previous prophets as well, when the opposition became extremely intense, what did they pray for? For victory. For a decision by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show the truth, to manifest the truth. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also made the same dua. So Allah will sooner or later decide and show who is right and who is wrong. Because remember, this is a Makki surah. And it was revealed towards the beginning part. And at that time, the opposition had just begun. The hostility had just begun. And at that time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sought help from who? Allah. That, O Allah, you have sent me, you take care of me. So this was Surah Al-Anbiya. And in this surah, we have learned about many prophets of Allah. about their lives, about their sacrifices, about their efforts, about their patience, about their struggle. And what's the main lesson in this surah for us? That there is only one way to success. There is only one straight way. And that is صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. And who are those whom Allah has favored upon? من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. So if a person wishes to be successful in this life and the hereafter, then what should he do? He should follow the way of the prophets of Allah. He should do what the prophets of Allah did. He should live his life according to the teachings of the messengers. And what is it that the prophets of Allah taught? The worship of Allah one. What is it that they showed? Reliance upon Allah alone. What is it that they did? Sabr over difficulties. And this is the way to success. Recitation.
وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الذِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ إِنَّ فِي هَذَا لَبَلَغًا.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.